Welcome to another video lecture of Make Mechanical Simple. See, today we are going to discuss a problem from the subject of mechanics of solids. This actually comes after the superposition principle, somewhat similar to what you have done in the previous lecture. Here, a bar ABCD is given, which is having a varying cross section. Varying cross section means it has different diameters at the different sections. Okay? And the important thing is, here the ends are fixed rather than it is free. The ends are fixed here, both the ends are fixed. The loads are acting at the intermediate sections. Here you can see a 50 kN is acting here and a 100 kN is acting here. And we have to find out what are the loads shared by each of the sections. That is, what will be the load acting in section 1, what will be the load acting in section 2, and what will be the load acting in section 3. So that means we have to actually determine P1, P2, P3. They are the load acting in each of the sections. And so that is a question, and we have given the diameters of these sections, the Young's modulus of the material. The material is steel, that's why the Young's modulus is 200 GPa. Okay, and the lengths are given 300 mm, 400 mm, and 500 mm respectively. Okay, so first of all, we have to find the load shared by each of the section. So how we'll do that? It's very easy, somewhat similar to what you have done in the previous lecture. So first step is, we have to split these sections into different regions like this. So here I already told you that we have to find these values P1, P2, P3. So for the time being we don't know that. So for the time being we can say the load acting in section 1 is P1, which is tensile in nature. So P1 is acting here, P1 is acting here, and here P2 is acting here, and here P3 is acting here. So all are tensile in nature for the time being. Okay, so I have, assuming that P1 is the load acting here, P2 is the load acting here, and P3 is the load acting here, and all these three loads have tensile nature. So now the biggest question is to how to solve these unknowns P1, P2 and P3. See, you know from the basic principle of mathematics, to solve three unknowns, we need definitely three equations. If you have three equations, you can easily solve three unknowns. So from where we can actually get these equations? That is a question. So two equations we can easily get from the equilibrium conditions. That is, here the resultant at the intermediate section, the resultant force acting at the intermediate section B is actually 50 kN. That is given. From that, we can actually make a compatibility equation. And similarly, the load acting at the intermediate section C is 100 kN. So from that also, we can form another compatibility equations. Now we have two equations. Okay, we can make two equations from that. So first we'll do that. So here the load acting, the resultant load acting is 50 kN, and that is towards the right. So that should be the resultant of these two loads, P1 and P2, right? So P1 is acting towards right and P2 is in the opposite direction. Okay. And 50 kN also acting towards right. Okay. So how we can write the compatibility equation here? P1 minus P2 is equal to 50 kN. This is P1 minus P2 is equal to 50 kN. So if you have any doubt, I will explain once again. See, P1 minus P2, that is the resultant of these two, should be this force. Okay, that is the logic here. In the same way, we can also write P2 minus P3, because P3 is in the opposite direction. P2 minus P3 is equal to 100 kN. Okay, so P3 minus P2 is equal to 100 kilonewton. Now we have two compatibility equations, but we have three unknowns. That's the problem. So from both we need one more equations to solve these unknowns. Then only we can solve these, find out the values of P1, P2 and P3. So from where we'll get the third equation? Do you have any idea? See, here we actually observing this figure, you'll get another condition. See, both the n's are fixed. Fixed means the total bar cannot move. Considering all these sections A, B, B, C, C, D together, the total deformation will be zero here. That is the third condition here. Okay, is that clear? The total deformation, that is the deformation of AB and deformation of BC and deformation of CD together is zero. Okay, so that means how we can express the same in mathematics, how we can express the same using equation, that is delta L1 plus delta L2 plus delta L3 is equal to 0. So delta L1 is the deformation in section 1, delta L2 is the deformation in section 2, and vice versa. So now we have to substitute the values of delta L1, delta L2 and delta L3. So how we can write that? P1 L1 divided by A1 E1 plus P2 L2 divided by A2 E2 plus P3 L3 divided by A3 E3 is equal to 0. So here whatever things are common you can cancel, because E is common here. So E actually you can strike out. Areas are different, lengths are different. So by solving this you can actually find the coefficients of P1, P2 and P3. Okay. So now we have equation 1, equation 2, equation 3, and the unknowns are P1, P2 and P3. You can easily solve these three equations in a calculator and you can find out the values of P1, P2 and P3. Once you got the values of P1, P2 and P3, we also asked to find out the deformation, the displacement of the point B and C. Displacement of the point B means what we have to find out? We have to find out the value delta L1, right? Delta L1. Okay. And displacement of point C means we have to find delta L3. That means this is the value we have to find, delta L3. So that you can do separately. And one more thing you have to take care. Here, initially we have assumed that all these three sections have tension nature. But that may be wrong. That's only our assumption. That may be wrong. Why? Because after solving, if any of the value P1, P2 or P3, if you are getting a negative value for P1 or P2 or P3, that means instead of tension, the nature of loading is compression in that particular section. Is that clear? Suppose you got the value of P3 as compression, value of P3 as a negative value. That means the load acting in the third section is actually compressive force instead of tensile force. Okay, so that you have to mention in the answer. You can mention it in the while you are writing down the answer. And whenever you get a negative value, you can put it in the bracket. The load acting is compression. Okay. So I hope you enjoyed my video. If you like my video, please click the subscribe button and share with your friends.